Hi everyone, welcome to this video on editing in Syncfusion Blazor Gantt chart. In this video, I will show you how to enable editing in Gantt chart and take you through the available editing modes. Then I will explain how to edit tasks using the taskbar and how to edit predecessors. After that, I will show you how to enable the toolbar and perform add operations with new row positions. Finally, I will show you how to enable deleting and explain how to edit using the context menu in Gantt chart. I'm using an existing WebAssembly application that was created during my Gantt chart getting started tutorial, and therefore all the necessary Gantt chart namespaces and components are pre-configured here. You can download this getting started sample from the link provided in the description below, and you can also watch my getting started video titled "Create a Gantt chart component in a Blazor WebAssembly application," which I have shared in the YouTube card. In the Getting Started tutorial, we saw how to bind hierarchical local list data to the Gantt chart. Also in that video, I explained how to enable filtering, the month timeline view mode, editing using the Gantt edit settings tag, and the allow editing property. In addition, I explained the dialog edit mode using the mode property. Using this mode property, I can also set the value to auto. First, let me show you how this dialog mode works. I run the application. You can see the Gantt chart with one parent task with two child tasks in the tree grid. The tree grid contains the columns ID, name, start date, end date, duration with a value 4 days for all tasks, and progress, meaning the completed work, which as of now is 50% for all tasks. The same is represented as a chart on the right side. The parent task is represented as taskbar with start and end dates in a gray color. The progress is represented in the dark gray color. Also, you can notice the child tasks are represented in a blue color with their start and end date. The progress is represented in dark blue. When I double click on the last row, the edit dialog opens. You can see the start date is June 9th and the end date is June 12th. This is because the duration of the task given is 4 days. I change the start date from June 9th to June 11th. Since the duration of the task is 4 days, the end date was automatically adjusted to June 16th. I click the Save button. You can see the changes have been updated in the tree grid for that row. Also, you will notice that the start date changes have affected the end date and duration of its parent row, where it was 4 days, but now it is 6 days. This is because one of its child tasks extended for 2 more days. You can see this reflected in the chart also. The parent task's end date has been changed along with its duration with respect to its child. Next, let me show you how the auto mode works. To change the edit mode to auto, I set the mode property with the value auto. I run the application. In the last row, I double click to edit the tree grid. This time, you can see the inline editor. I change the value. Notice that the value is updated in the tree grid and in the chart. When I double click on the last row in the chart, the edit dialog opens. I edit the value and click save. You can see the changes in both controls. This is the behavior of the auto settings. When editing is performed on the tree grid, an inline editor is open, and when editing is performed on the chart, the editor dialog is open. Now, let me show you how to edit a task using the taskbar. In the Gantt edit settings tag, I add the allow taskbar editing property and set the value to true. I run the application. When I hover over the last row's taskbar, you will notice the kebab menus at the start and end points of the taskbar. I can select the taskbar and drag to change the start and end dates. You can notice the parent taskbar also changes with respect to the child taskbar. Also using the kebab menu, I can change the start date and end date of the task. Using the progress bar navigator, I can change the progress value for the child task. You can notice the parent task's progress also changes with respect to the child. Now, let me show you how to edit the predecessor. As I explained in my data binding video, predecessor is a field that contains information about the task ID that precedes a task. This information helps the Gantt chart identify the predecessor tasks from the data source, and then draw dependency arrow marks between the tasks. So let me add the predecessor field to my data source. In the task data class, I add a predecessor property of type string. In the data creation method, for the third task, I add the predecessor property and set the value with the task ID value 2. The task with ID 2 will precede the task with ID 3. To show this column in the Gantt charts tree grid, in the Gantt task field stack, I set the dependency property with the field name predecessor. Now I run the application. You can see the Gantt chart with the task dependencies annotated arrow marks. Task 2 precedes task 3. In the tree grid, you can see the dependency column. For the third task, the dependency is added as 2FS. This means task 3 is preceded with task 2 in a finish to start relationship. Finish to start is the default task relationship. There are 4 types of task relationships in total. They are start to start, where you cannot start a task until the dependent task also starts; start to finish, where you cannot finish a task until the dependent task is started; finish to start, where you cannot start a task until the dependent task is completed; and finish to finish, where you cannot finish a task until the dependent task is completed. Now, let me edit the task relationship from finish to start to start to start. In the dependency column, I edit the value and change the value to 2SS. Now, you can see the task relationship changes to start to start in the chart. Also, I can edit the connector line directly using the connector line UI. Let me delete the existing task relationship. In the taskbar, I hover over the second task and you will notice the connector points on both sides. I just drag the end connector to the third task connector at the starting point. You can see the tooltip explaining the task relationship that is going to be established. I drop the connector and you can see the task relationship has been established between tasks 2 and 3. If I try to establish an invalid task relationships, the connector lines will show an invalid icon. For example, let me try to connect task 2 with the task 3 endpoint. Since there is already a relationship, it shows the invalid icon and rejects the connection. Also, there is no tooltip suggestion provided. When I hover over the connector lines, it explains the relationship between the two tasks. Notice the lag is listed as 0 here, which means there are no delays between the execution of these two tasks. I can add a delay by editing the dependency column. Predecessor offsets can be defined with 3 duration units. They are day, hour, and minute. To delay a task for 1 day, I just add plus 1D. You can see that 1 day is added to the chart. And while I hover over the connector, you can see the lag is listed as 1 day. If I need to start 1 day before the end date of the second task, I add minus 1D in the dependency column. Now you can see the third task starts 1 day before the second task ends. The tooltip also states the lag is minus 1 day. Also, I can edit the dependency using the dialog. I double click on the task, the information dialog opens, and in the dependency tab, I can edit the dependency, add or delete the dependency. Next, let me show you how to add a new task. In the Gantt edit settings tag, I add the allow adding property and set the value to true. To add a task in the Gantt chart, I need a user interface to achieve it. Here, I can use a toolbar and its built-in add option. In total, there are 10 inbuilt toolbar items. They are add, cancel, collapse all, delete, edit, expand all, next time span, previous time span, search, and update. To show the add user interface in the Gantt chart, in the SF Gantt tag, I add the toolbar property and set the value as a list of type string with the value add. Now I run the application. You can see the add button in the toolbar. I click the add button and the dialog opens with the pre-configured values in the fields. The ID is auto-incremented and the name field contains the value new task 4, which is based on the ID 4. The start date and end date are generated based on the existing parent's start date, which is June 9, 2020. The default duration set here is 1 day and the progress is 0. Let me change the start date to June 11 and change the end date to June 12 and click Save. You can see the new task with ID 4 is added at the top row in the control. The default row position is top, but I can customize it using the new row position property. To set the new row position, in the Gantt Edit Settings tab, I add the new row position property, and then I can set any of the values above, below, bottom, child, and top. I will choose the option child and run the application. I select the parent row so that I can add the new item as its child. I click the add button and provide the field values and click save. You can see the task with ID 4 is added as a child. Next, let me show you how to delete a task. To enable deleting, in the Gantt Edit Settings tab, I add the allow deleting property and set the value to true. In the toolbar property, I add the values edit and delete so that I can use the user interfaces for the edit and delete operations. Now I run the application. I select a task. You can see the toolbar with edit and delete options enabled. When I click the delete button, the selected row is removed from the Gantt chart. If I delete the parent row, all its child tasks will be removed from the Gantt chart as well. I can perform all these edit, add, and delete operations using a context menu. To enable the context menu, in the SF Gantt tag, I add the enable context menu property and set the value to true. I run the application, select the last row, and right-click to show the context menu. Here, you can see the options to show the task information, which is where I can edit the values. Here, I also have the delete task option and the add option, which I can use to add tasks above or below, add a child, and add a milestone. Let me select the milestone option. You can see the milestone is added to the Gantt chart. Milestones are flags that show that the project has completed a set of tasks towards the goal. I edit the name of the milestone to Project Initiated. Also, using the context menu, I can delete a dependency, convert a task to a milestone or a milestone to a task, and add indents and outdents to a task. That's everything. Let me summarize the main points I covered. I explained the steps to configure editing and discussed the available editing modes, and then I explained how to edit tasks using the taskbar and how to edit predecessors. Then I demonstrated how to enable the toolbar and perform add operations with new row positions. Finally, I showed how to enable deleting and explained how to edit using the context menu in the Gantt chart. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the video description below. You can also see about getting a free license key to use our Blazor products if you are eligible for our community license. If you found this video useful, click the like button and subscribe to our channel to get notifications about new videos. Thanks for watching.